Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the press briefing for the launching of our 30th Independence Anniversary celebrations. I will ask you to please rise for the playing of the national anthem.
Good morning, everyone. Please, you may sign yourselves in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Okay. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this new day. We thank you for the grace to be alive. We thank you that we have health and strength. And even as we are coming here today to launch our Independence 38 celebration activities, Father, we ask that you will bless us. Bless the proceedings here today, and I pray that everything will be done to your honor and your glory, that we will truly be able to celebrate our existence as a nation. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for keeping us throughout so many trials. Father, we thank you for victories. We thank you for everything, Lord, and we thank you for the peace that you have granted in our nation. Lord, we bless you, and we ask that you'll continue to be with us and continue to guide us. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Mr. Frederick. Everyone, please be seated. Once again, a pleasant good morning to everyone. My name is Nicole McDonald. I'm the Senior Communications Officer for the government. Thank you very much to the members of the media for being with us here this morning in such large numbers for this press briefing. I would like to take the opportunity to also thank the members of the Independence Committee who are here this morning. I know you guys have been working very hard over the last few weeks to ensure that we have a calendar of events that we can be proud of for our 30th Independence celebrations. I would now like to introduce our esteemed guests here this morning. We have the Honorable Fortuna Bellrose, who's our Minister in the Ministry of Equity, Social Justice, Empowerment, Youth Development, Sports, Culture, and Local Government. Good morning. We also have with us the Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Culture and Local Government, Mr. Donovan Williams. We would now like to head straight into our presentations this morning. We will start with some opening remarks from the Minister, Honorable Fortuna Bellrose. Minister.
Thank you very much, Nicole. Permanent Secretary within the Ministry of, or the Department of Local Government and Culture, ladies and gentlemen, sons and daughters of Saint Lucia, it is the 30th anniversary of independence. As I say 38, my thoughts are racing through my mind, and I trust that you too will engage in your own reflection on what this significant occasion means. As citizens of Fair Helen, we must all be concerned about where our country is, where it is headed, and most importantly, the role that we each must play and can play in keeping it on track. For us Saint Lucians, the proud children of Jean-Baptiste Bidault, Flo Gaia, George Charles, Sir Arthur Lewis, Sir Alan Luizzi, George Odlam, Sir John Compton, Dame Sessin Descartes, Sir Dwight Venner, and oh yes, Roddy and Sir Derek Walcott. Independence is a time when we unite, when we put our differences aside and focus on the things that make us unique and hardcore Lucian. The things we share, the things we care about, the things we are passionate about, like striving against all odds to be the best that we can be, being leaders and not mere followers, giving of ourselves to help others, providing for our families, and sharing the little that we have with our neighbors. And above all, respecting each other and holding on to the old adage, doing unto others as we would have them do unto us. It is these basic values of caring, loving, sharing, and giving that helps us define our Saint Lucianness And it is those very attributes we need to propel our country forward, as they keep us in a constant proactive state, ever conscious of our space and focus on achieving greatness. The reality is, some of us are not in that place where peace and tranquility reign supreme. For many, there is chaos and disharmony. For those who may feel that disconnect, this is the time for a rethink on what being Saint Lucian truly is. This year, under the chairmanship of Mr. Donovan Williams, we have created an abundance of opportunities for you to engage, to learn, and to get the right orientation about us, Lucians, about our history, and about our heritage as a people, so you can truly evaluate where you are and rethink how you can become even more meaningfully involved in the development of your country. Our programs cover events across the country, across the length and breadth of our country, catering to families, communities, and organizations. I therefore challenge every Saint Lucian to let your passion for your country, that place that gave you birth, reverberate across Fair Helen during the celebrations. Participate because it's your right. Participate because it's your business and it's your opportunity to make a statement as a Saint Lucian who want to be counted, a proud Saint Lucian. You see, to move Saint Lucia, we all must act, and there is no better time than now. Our celebrations this year will be underpinned by a focus on spirituality, recognizing the supremacy of God, the Almighty Creator, Maker, and a Friend, and that we can only celebrate 38 years because of His goodness and His mercy towards all of us. I also wish to note that this year's celebration coincides with two important milestones in our history: the 50th anniversary of our flag, which was designed by Honorable Dunstan Sentoma on the attainment of statehood in 1967, and the 50th anniversary of the elevation of the city of Castries, or the of Castries as a city. This provides us with an opportunity to infuse these two within our overall celebrations and our learning. As you know, our government recently established an events company to oversee the organization and delivery of all major national events and festivals. It was too soon to include independence in its portfolio of events this year, but the organization of the independence activities from next year will certainly be the responsibility of that organization. In addition, the institution, of course, will have even more time to prepare and engage and ensure that we deliver a quality product, an even better quality product, next year for independence. But the key to the successful delivery of our independence programs this year, my friends, sons and daughters of St. Lucia, is the extent to which you as citizens, as organizations, participate in the program of activities that is planned. So I urge you to become involved. I urge you to embrace the celebrations as it is ours. Let us participate, let us make it relevant, and let us enjoy it. I thank you.
Thank you, Minister, for that very fitting, positive message. As we begin our 30th celebrations, we're already a little bit into February, so I'm sure there's a lot of people already celebrating. I think our diaspora has already began their activities. I want to thank you also for the history lesson you just gave us in terms of our national flag and in terms of the city of Castries. This is definitely information that definitely our young people should know, and all Saint Lucians should know. I hope that there's some kind of trivia exercise in some of the activities. Speaking of the activities, we have now our permanent secretary in the Department of Culture and Local Government to give you an overview of the activities and, of course, to also launch the theme and the logo for independence. Mr. Donovan Williams.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister for Culture and Local Government, Junabel Rose, members of the Independence Committee. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning.
Morning.
Our task as a committee was, I think, very, very simple. And it was underpinned by one overriding philosophy, that we really had to make independence truly engaging for all of our citizens. We wanted to ensure that independence was not business as usual, something that happens and then quickly forgotten as we go through our daily routines, etc. We wanted our citizens to be and to feel part of the celebrations. And so it meant for us looking very critically at what we did traditionally to see how we could do it better, and also to introduce new, different, dare I say, exciting events that could capture the attention of persons who previously would not have wanted to have been part of this activity. And so starting with the theme, we had many a discussion, many a debate about what that theme should be. There were persons who felt that there was no need for a theme. There were others who thought that our theme should be so designed as to have people really thinking. I think generally we agreed on a couple of characteristics of how this theme should be manifested. First, it should be basic, not too long, not too unwieldy, not too difficult for people to take in and understand. Secondly, it certainly should be one that could and should engage people. And engage people, engage different groups in our society, but also at different levels. Also, we felt that the theme, for it to be truly relevant, had to be a statement of intent, had to be an opportunity to reflect, had to be an avenue for discussion and discourse, and had to allow our people to give different perspectives on it and to show it in different ways. And so we needed a theme that would tick all of those boxes. We actually came down to two. And again, we had a lot of discussion and debate about those two. The first, again, very simple, I am Saint Lucian. And if you think about it, it does tick all of the boxes. Because it's an affirmation of who we are. It provides us with an opportunity to articulate and showcase our Saint Lucian-ness, as Minister highlighted. But it also provides us with a platform to question what it is to be a Saint Lucian and what are the characteristics of a Saint Lucian. But in the final analysis, in our discussions and deliberations, we made a slight variation to that theme. And so the theme that we have selected for the 30th anniversary is I am Saint Lucia. I am Saint Lucia. And again, if you reflect on that theme, it ticks all of the previous characteristics that I described. But I think the one central difference is the point that it wants to make to all of us, and the point that we should keep with us beyond this period of celebration, but throughout the year and throughout the years. Ultimately, Saint Lucia is what we individually and collectively make of it. And so when we say, I am Saint Lucia, if we contribute to the positives we will have a positive Saint Lucia. If we contribute to the negatives, we will have a negative Saint Lucia. And the time is ripe for us to have a serious discussion and dialogue about what we want Saint Lucia to be, and to use independence to broaden that dialogue, to use independence to get the views of the diverse sections of our population to tell us what it is that Saint Lucia should be and how we get there, and where are the examples of persons who have contributed to Saint Lucia in a positive way, and how can we emulate them. That is the nature of the discourse, that is the nature of the celebration, that is the nature of the entire package that we want to be focused on this year. In terms of the logo, again, we had a lot of discussion, a lot of dialogue, a lot of debate about what that logo should be, what it should signify, how do we represent it. And again, we've tried to be as simplistic as possible. We want to demonstrate, or we wanted to have symbols of our pride as a people. We wanted to have a depiction of the radiance, the positivity that is what we should be about. And we also wanted to demonstrate an act of pursuing excellence. And we thought there would be nothing better than having one of our major symbols, our parrot, carrying our flag. Carrying our flag as a symbol of where we want to be, what we want to do. Carrying our flag with pride, carrying our country with pride. We are Saint Lucia. The activities that we will unveil and which you have before you, I must tell you, is a snapshot of all of the activities that will take place. It's physically impossible to have placed in this document all of the activities that are being celebrated. And I must say that we have been inundated with initiatives for inclusion. And not all of them, that's also very encouraging, not all of them have been initiatives requiring direct financial support. Again, it tells us that we have people who are resourceful and who are prepared to take on the responsibility of implementing activities even without a level of financial support. The diversity of the activities and the initiatives, I think, is very, very impressive. Not just from the types of activities, but also from where they are coming from. And again, in an era where we have often spoken about trying to move away from being Castries and North-centric to ensuring that we span all of the regions in our country, this set of activities is very much representative of that. And so I want to underscore the fact that this calendar is not necessarily reflective of all. And as we move further and further towards the Independence Day itself, we will be updating and informing you of many other activities that are going to be taking place. So from our perspective, and I want to underscore the minister's point, our success is really going to be measured against the level and the nature of participation of all of our citizens. And I want to again underscore Minister's point to encourage all of us, to truly take part in these activities. We are really what Saint Lucia is to be. And so the theme, I am Saint Lucia, must be part of how we look at independence, how we encourage and engage more and more persons, so that in the end, it is the positive spirit that we bring to bear that will ultimately redound to the benefit of our country, Saint Lucia. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Williams. Thank you very much. I want to repeat your call for all Saint Lucians to invoke the theme which we have launched and think about what it really means to them. I am Saint Lucia. We are definitely all Saint Lucia. Wherever we are in the world, we remain Saint Lucians. As I speak of what's going on in the world, I want to turn our attention to the screen because our Prime Minister, Honorable Alan Michael Chastney, delivered a message to the diaspora in anticipation of the 30th Independence Anniversary celebrations, and we will be playing that now for the audience.
As we celebrate the 30th anniversary of our independence, this year's theme is I Am Saint Lucia. And I have to tell you that your government has been working very hard to bring substance to that theme. We have so many new investments coming into this country. We've been trying to bring back the hope and inspire people. I'm very excited that we've been able to reduce the VAT rate from 15% to 12.5%. And next month we'll be able to announce major new projects that are coming to Saint Lucia. Included in those is the Pearl of the Caribbean, a landmark project that would really put Saint Lucia on the world map. But we need more help. We need help from you. You have been doing an amazing job in the diaspora, carrying that flag and all being saying out loud, I am Saint Lucia. You're living it every day, and we need your help more than ever before. We need your help in continuing to support the efforts of all our social programs. We need your help in investing in Saint Lucia. And very soon, we're going to need your help to come back to Saint Lucia and lend assistance to help us build a new Saint Lucia. I want to thank you for all the efforts you've made over the last years, especially after the disasters we've had. Your contributions have gone a long way in keeping the flame alive here in Saint Lucia. We have difficult times. We've seen some of the horror stories of our young people killing each other. This is a big challenge for the government, but I've given the population of St. Lucia the assurance that the justice system is going to be priority number one. We have some difficult times, but we have some great opportunities. We have two new hospitals going to be opening up, and obviously this is a huge financial challenge for the government. But we're going to be standing tall to make sure that all St. Lucians will be so proud of their new healthcare system in St. Lucia. I also want to say to you that we need your help in lobbying other governments to make sure that the voice of Saint Lucia and our concerns are heard. We need to make sure you're out there as our greatest ambassadors in promoting this world-class destination. I also want to say to you that members of my cabinet will be out with you very soon. We want to create new opportunities for you to come back home and invest. We have a new sovereign fund that we're going to be putting together, an ability for you to be able to invest money into Saint Lucia and make sure that this is going towards the development of this country. So again, on this 30th anniversary, let's all be proud and say, I am Saint Lucia. Happy anniversary, Saint Lucia.
Thank you very much to the Honorable Prime Minister for that message that went out to the diaspora on Saturday evening at a gospel fest that was planned in New York that went over very well. And apparently they also took some collections in terms of charity there for people who are affected at home by crime, by health issues. So I definitely want to thank the very active organizations around the world, Saint Lucian organizations that continue to remember what's going on in Saint Lucia and continue to try to make a contribution to assist, which lends to the idea that no matter where you are Saint Lucia, you know, and we know that they are aware of what's going on in this country with the advent of social media. They can keep in contact at all times with what's happening here at home. So thank you very much. Also, I do want to say that I was reading this morning that at 38, is when a woman is very sure of herself and where she's going. So I definitely know that Helen, turning 38, she knows where she's going, and she's definitely going to be sure of herself. You know, it's 2 years from 40, which for some women can be a good or a bad thing. But I think for definitely for St. Lucia, 38 and going into her 40s, St. Lucia will have a lot to be proud of, especially if we as a nation come together. We want to go straight into some presentations by committee members who have been involved in the process in terms of planning the long list of activities we have planned. Obviously, like the permanent secretary said, the list does not include everything that will be happening, but we wanted to highlight and give persons the opportunity to basically market some of the activities that they're involved in. I want to start by inviting Mr. Teddison Glasgow to come up to the podium and explain to us some of the sporting activities that are going on for Independence 38. Mr. Glasgow.
Thank you, Ms. McDonald. Of course, good morning to government officials here. Indeed, it's a pleasure for me to be here as the 38th Independence Anniversary. As the speakers before mentioned, various sorts of activities have been planned for Independence celebration. But I do like the theme, as a matter of fact. I am St. Lucia. What it really says is that we have to sell ourselves first. I guess it will all filter down to our country. And of course, we all know that sports plays an integral role in terms of development of a nation, building of a nation. So you see on the program of activities, it's laden with a lot of sporting activities. In terms of tennis, which is the Independence Tennis Tournament, it's already started. That's being held probably every other day on weekends as well at the St. Lucia National Tennis Center. A lot of young kids, a lot of categories are involved, which means that if you're a tennis enthusiast learning the game, you will be part of this tournament. It moves on. We have seen the commencement of the Independence Netball Tournament, which is an island-wide tournament because there are various venues. Of course, the main venue would be the VG Multipurpose Sports Complex, but it brings again the going around the island, because as the Permanent Secretary mentioned, it's not only Castries or North-centric. We have to spread our development and our involvement island-wide. So netball has been played quite across the island. We move on to the Independence Table Tennis Championship. Again, that's already started. The house for this championship is the Bossejou Indoor Facility, and it is currently being continuing. Table tennis, of course, in itself, we know about our history, one-time powerhouse in the OACS, but it brings enthusiasm when it comes to youth, and we must engage the youth in terms of sport, because they are the future of sport, and they're also the future of our nation, St. Lucia. That's why I love this theme. I am St. Lucia. And if anybody knows me, I am St. Lucia. We continue with from February 11th to the 21st, where we'll see the Prime Minister's Cup, which is the T20 Cricket Championship. Last year, loads of crowd followed this championship all over the island again. We know of how powerful St. Lucians are in terms of voicing their opinions, and we know of the national word. It is often used at this championship. When you see those players hit those sixes and fours, trust me, they get all over it. Again, it's in VF4, it's in Mabio Valley, it's in Denry, it's in Soufre, it's all over, not based one location. So I'm looking forward to that. And of course, the PS and the minister as well mentioned that we have to sell our own, or we have to participate. And I love that too. Because if we don't participate or if we don't spectate, imagine playing a sport and there is no audience. Those players are not going to be alive. They're just going to be playing for playing sake. But if we go out and participate and be part of the tournaments or the championships, they get more involved and it gets more exciting. And again, it's independence. Let's go out there and participate. As I look on further down in terms of the program, I will now call on Mr. Walter Berkeley, who is the PRO for the Trail Finders Off-Road Club. They too have an event, and it's going to be held at a very unique location. I like the name, as a matter of fact. It's called Cow City Cul-de-sac. And earlier on, somebody said, Cow City? And I had to tell them, yes, because they know of the Millennium Highway, how it's set up now. But back in the days, I can tell you, it was laden with cows. It was like a valley, cul-de-sac valley. A lot of cows, a lot of leech as well, because we get cows, you get that. There's a very kind of swamp area. The highway was nothing of the sort. So Cow City is quite fitting. Same way we have Sulphur City for Soufre, I think that is quite fitting for Calissa, Cow City. So we now call on Mr. Walter Berkeley just to give us an insight in terms of the independence 4x4 words, 4x4 wars, that is. And I'll be back just to give you in terms of a little more in terms of events, sporting events, that is, for the 30th anniversary independence. Mr. Berkeley.
Honorable Minister, Permanent Secretary, our host, press and other invited persons, I'd first like to thank the committee and all the government agencies that made it so possible for me to stand here today, because we are a very young group, and speak about this event, the first one and the first time we're having such an event for independence. What we're going to be doing is that, again, our group Trail Finders deals with off-roading and going on trails and basically nowhere you want to drive a vehicle. We like to go there. And what we've done, we've taken Cow City. Again, he was explained very nicely. If you're going down south of Millennium Highway, the place with all the cows and the mud, that's where we're going to be. We've created a nice track, beautiful, all right, with a lot of obstacles. We have persons coming from Barbados, St. Vincent, hopefully Trinidad, quite a number of persons coming down to deal with mud pits, climbing rocks, big holes in the dirt. We set up our track nicely, okay? Also, we're going to have, on that same day when we start at 9 o'clock, we want to open both our races. We have two major races there to anybody in the public, okay, with a 4x4 that wants to take part. Of course, we want to keep it as very organized as possible, so you'll have to come and just register for that event, so we don't just have people driving onto the track. But it's going to be open for anybody to come, and trust me, it's going to be something different, and we're going to like it. If you like mud, you like off-roading, we St. Lucians, we like a little rough road. So come down, it's going to be fun, 9 o'clock. Yes. we used to the rough roads in St. Lucia. But it will be a great event. It's the first time we're looking for the support of everybody. Come out and support us. It's free. There will be music, of course, concession stands. Come out and enjoy it. And hopefully next year you'll see us there again. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Berkeley. Of course, we mentioned, you just heard it well, we've sent Lucians. So a lot of what is planned by the committee is all in the realm of being true St. Lucians. That's why I go again. I love the theme. I am St. Lucia. Moving on with other activities, February 18th to the 19th is what's called the Independence Drag Race Battle. Of course, you know what that is. There's a lot about drag racing. It seems to be drawing quite a bit of a crowd. It's something new. And again, we moved away from the traditional ways of doing things. So when you hear of drag racing, it's new to St. Lucia. So why not go out and see what it is? Participate, be part of it. Okay, on the program it is, I think this is a big one as a matter of fact. It is the main event, if you ask, when it comes to sports, especially when it comes to independence. It's the National Sports Awards, February 18th, National Cultural Center, from 7 p.m. This is where everybody who's played their part in sports, if you know, a top flight player, participant, administrator, whatever role you play in sports, this is your night. Not everybody's going to be rewarded, but we all know it's girl. The sportswoman and sportsman of the year, junior and senior, they are the major ones highlighted. Also, in terms of sporting associations, they're going to be highlighted as well. But that is their night of reward. So the committee put together a nice little function where it's sort of like a little, it's becoming a red carpet function, because you get to see sporting persons in a different light, no longer in the tights or whatever, but everybody is decked out in their nice dress and guys in their suits and ties and bow ties. So the Sports Awards is definitely one to mark on your calendar to be part of. February 19th continues with the Independence Dash Color Run. I like this. Dash Color Run. What can I say? It's a colorful event which involves running. From Massey Stores, Shock Bay to Rodney Bay from 6 a.m. It is another event that you would want to be part of. If you're not a runner, at least you could walk fast. to be just say you were part of it. So the Dash Color Run is another one to look forward to. Another event on February 19th is one which has become traditional, or a staple event rather, is the Monipo Road Relay. You often hear about it, but now is the chance to be part of it. So all those other organizations, you don't have to be, for example, because you have road running, that you have to be a road runner. You could be a footballer, a cricketer, put a team together. Again, it's organized by the Department of Youth Development and Sports, along with the Monipo Committee. And we have Mr. Glenn Wilson to give us some more information on that event.
Honorable Minister Belrose, Permanent Secretary Mr. Williams, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so very much for the opportunity to speak to you about our Independence Road Relay held in the great state of Monrepo on the 19th of February this month, the great state of Monrepo. 10 years after Saint Lucia became an independent nation, a few persons from the great state of Monrepo decided to put together an event that would sort of be a signature event for the community. And so this year we'll be celebrating 28 years that we are hosting an Independence Road Relay in Monrepo. The event has grown from strength to strength. We've been having participation from a lot of local clubs, teams, organizations, as well as regional clubs participating. And from the inception, we had MATNIC, which has been a constant participant in our road relay. We've changed our route slightly last year. We wanted to make it more communal, so our route usually took us to 1A in Viewfort. And so we decided that we wanted to make it something more community-based, and so we wanted to involve other communities around, so including the Mikut village. So we've changed the route slightly. All of the information is available on our website. It's mrysc.org. On there, we have all the routes already plotted out, so the aerial views of the route and how long they are, where they would take you to, and we've tried to do it as much as possible in communities. So some of the routes will take you actually inside of Monrepo itself and through the Mikut village. And on our way back, the fifth leg would go to Elen, which is just past Dairy Sugap. And then coming back, we will go back to the Wen playing field in Monrepo, where the activities will continue with fun games and other events geared at bringing people together, building families, and so forth. This year, one of the things that we've added to our road relay is that we will be showing, we'll be airing the event, all of the event, live at the Wen playing field. So persons can view the leg, the persons participating in the relay. So we'll have a big screen at Wen playing field where persons can come and sit and have fun, bring your family and everybody else with you and watch the race from the Wen playing field. It's an activity that we've been having for quite some time, and I want to encourage all St. Lucians to participate. As was mentioned before, it is not just clubs, but individuals can register. It's an eight-leg event, so eight persons. Registration forms, rules, guidelines, and all those things are available on our website, as I mentioned, mrysc.org, and all information is on there. This Saturday also, we'll be celebrating a smaller event with one of our affiliates, Grass Street Youth and Sports Council. On the 11th, we'll be having the Kevin Malcolm Memorial 5K, which is in memory of one of its members who died from cancer, and it's now geared towards providing scholarship funds for persons attending the Monrepo and Passions Combined Schools. So this event is scheduled for this Saturday, the 11th of February. And then next week, Sunday, the 19th, all roads lead to the Wen playing field in the great state of Monrepo. Thank you so very much.
Thank you for that. The great state of Monrepo. I like that because it's an area I'm very much familiar. You mentioned an area there, I think you said, Ellen. For those who's not too familiar where that is, that is just after the Dairy Sugap, you get the bridge. And there's a little community on the left-hand side of the road, right, correct? That's that area. And the Wen, you need to go into the community, go enter to the left, and then you make your way down the hill to get onto the Wen playing field. Moving on, earlier we mentioned about the Independence Drag Race. And I was a little worried because I was saying, but this is a new event with a lot of excitement. Guess what? Mr. Montoot, who is the president, is here to fill us in. And then we're going to move on to the Moto X Club, where Mr. Daniel Louis will fill us in as well. So we now call on the president, Mr. Montoot.
Good day to all. Honorable Minister, Secretary, Ms. McDonald. I'm here from Timeline Events. We're no stranger to drag racing in St. Lucia. It is one of the staple events that is celebrated almost every holiday. Thank you. Timeline Events has been a clubbing organization for, we've been here for about 4 years. We've had about 4 to 5 events. We were the guys who actually put our Prime Minister, and I will guide Joseph into two sports cars and send them down the track. The video is actually on our page timeline events. So this event, it's a two-day event. We have some three cars coming from St. Vincent.
So are you saying you're going to invite the minister?
They are welcome. We're actually going to try it again. Right. As a matter of fact, everyone is invited. The structure this time is that we will be having three cars coming from St. Vincent, some bikes from Dominica, some bikes from Barbados as well. And of course, our local drivers will be there to take on the event. So it's a two-day event. First day is Test and Tune. The last day is the grudge matches, where everybody gets excited to actually see some of the fastest cars go all out at the event. So all are welcomed. Check out our Facebook page, Timeline Events, and we'll see you there, 18th and 19th. Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Montwood. I don't know if you folks have realized, but as much as it is all about St. Lucia, some of the planning of some of the events rather have gone regional. You see invitations now to Dominica, Martinique, Trinidad and Tobago, Barbados. So definitely we are getting out there. That's what we need more of, you know. Too much in time that we have tailored our events for our own people. We are St. Lucia and we are warm and hospitable, so hence the reason why we can host persons to come across. We move on now to the Independence Bikers Super Moto event. That's February 19th at the Castries Waterfront. Mr. Daniel Louis will fill us in with more information.
First, I would like to say good day to the Honorable Minister, PS, and our host here, Nicole McDonald. My name is Daniel Louis, President of the St. Lucia Moto X Club. I'd first like to start off by given the existence of our club. It's 24 years old, and we started going to St. Vincent as a motorcycle club for their independence some years ago. And this has created a movement amongst the biking fraternity and other islands wanting to do the same. As part of this year activities, we'll be hosting clubs from St. Vincent, Martinique, Guadeloupe, Grenada, Dominica, and Tobago. We have a total of 150 bikes coming to the island, and over 200 persons. I expected, along with audio song cars, we have drag cars, and we have, of course, the off-roaders. It's expected that these persons from these clubs will be arriving on the 16th, from the 16th of February. Our activities slated is the welcome party, where we'll be hosting it at the old Sunset Motors Yard, where we're going to have all our invited guests, all our foreigners come in and congregate so we could get them familiar with our activities for the independence. On the 18th, we have a song clash, where we have all our cars from St. Vincent, Barbados with the audio. They will be competing with our guys from St. Lucia. That is the St. Lucia Auto Sound Club. So then and again, we'll have like a regional competition. The 19th, I'm going to talk about this event, Supermoto. That is something that we held for the first time in the city of Castries, which created a carnival impact in the front of the Castries market. And of course, we know that this time around, it will be bigger. And of course, moving along to our island ride, with all those foreigners, all those bikes coming into the island from Dominica, Martinique, Barbados, St. Vincent, Grenada, Tobago. I mean, that's a day that we all look forward to. We attend the parade, and then after, we go sightseeing around our island. And we take our foreigners and we get them to know the island. So we take that trip through West Coast and come around through the East. I would like to thank the government and the Independence Committee for inviting us to be part of this 38th year celebration. Thank you on behalf of all the members of the St. Lucia Moto X Club. We're looking forward to collaborate with the government in the future. We're looking forward to see St. Lucia come out and support the festivities planned by the Independence Committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief. In terms of what you mentioned, in terms of the Supermoto event at the Cassius Waterfront near the market area, I can tell you I attended that event last year. I was very much pleased with what I saw. So if you have a doubt of what Mr. Daniel Louis mentioned, make sure that you're part of it, because it is something that especially the youngsters, they're thrilled to see that motorbike go up and come back down and land tires. You guys had it made. So again, it's a new type of event, and this is what we're moving away from, traditional stuff to introduce new events that persons can get interested in. It all falls in line with why we are St. Lucians. We really appreciate the innovation and what you guys are doing. On February 19th, there's also the Independence Autocross. That's in VFO at 9 a.m. That's put on by the Association of Assorted Motoring Advancement. And 19th as well, this is the Free Stage Invitational Cycle Race by the St. Lucia Cycle Association. Again, the Cassius Waterfront, 2:30 p.m. If you remember clearly back in the days, you would hear, move off the track, keep off the track. That is St. Lucian. And that is what we want to see we reintroduce, where we saw those guys go around the city circuit. And, you know, persons would be so excited. I think it was the Ovaltine or something at that given point. That's why it was. So we need that injection of those sports. They need the support. But how do we do it? By selling it, by ensuring that the association goes out and engage their members first, and thereby create that buzz that persons would want to be part of it. Moving on again, on the February 21st, it's called the Independence Walkathon. I think it's more than a walkathon, because actually it is a challenge. And that is put on by the Northern Long Distance Walking Group. They're going to go around the island, so it's not a walkathon, I can tell you. It's a challenge in itself. To give you more information on this, we're going to call on Mr. Wayne Monrose, who represents the Northern Long Distance Walking Group.
Good morning, Honorable Minister, Honorable PS, Madam Chairperson, ladies and gentlemen. The Northern Long Distance Group really is a group of avid walkers. Over the years, over 30 years as a group, we've been walking, and we formalized ourselves and formed this group, and from henceforth, we decided on different activities, and that was the birth of the walk around the island. This walk is really a challenge, a challenge for everyone who wants to challenge themselves. While the ultimate is that of the finishing, where we start at Cul-de-sac, we go through the west coast, all around, and we end up back onto the boulevard, that's where it ends. But the objective is to challenge everyone to challenge themselves. So while we hope everyone could get to the finish line, you don't have to get there. You could decide to stop at Anslery, stop at Canneries, anywhere that you choose. The average walk is 24 hours. And this is not to fear you. We start at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. We go all across. It is really to ensure that you get yourself prepared in advance, to necessary that you have all that is important for you to complete it. We have decided that everyone is a winner. You don't have to finish it, as I said earlier on. If you're interested and you get involved, you don't have to finish to be a winner. It is free. Registration is free. It is an 88-mile challenge. You need to take note of that. And there is a documentary out which was done in the 2016th walk. It is on YouTube. 88 miles of endurance. I want to ask everybody to have a look at this documentary. It's a very interesting documentary. It really gives you an idea of what we are all about and what is involved in the walk. One of the things we wanted to ensure here was that we do not create any sort of, when you use 88 miles of endurance, is to ensure that persons listening don't feel so worried or fearsome that they may not want to challenge it. And this is why the departure this year is really to encourage persons to challenge themselves. Forget the 88 miles if you cannot do it, if you do 10, 20, 30, 40, whatever. And that is the objective. We want to also remind persons that registration is free. And we'll be having a meeting on the 9th. It was supposed to be at the town hall. That has changed, and I hope we may be able to get the Ministry of of sports to allow us to use their facility because I'm told that repairs are being done there. So we'll advise the public that on the 9th and on the 16th, these are the two meetings we'll have. Please come in, we'll give you more information and all the necessary things. I could go among the list of things that you'd need to do to prepare yourself, but I'm sure we can do that at that meeting. So again, it's a 88-mile challenge, and we welcome St. Lucians to be part of it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Monrose. You mentioned it's an 88-mile challenge. What I want to say now, it's a 48-year challenge in terms of Independence Anniversary, and I challenge St. Lucians to be St. Lucians. Moving on, we look at the Independence Volleyball Championship from February 24th to 25th. Very interesting, too. Going to be held at the Boss Issue in the facility. We know that our history in terms of volleyball started right next door at the VG Sports Complex 1986, if I remember clearly, because I was a ball retriever at that time, where we took over and we've been dominant. So it's another sport that's need your support as well. February 25th, it is the Independence Rugby Sevens Tournament. And when you have rugby, you think, oh my God, it's going to be some rough stuff. But what they have done, they have tweaked it a bit in terms of the seven. So I guess you need seven individuals to participate. It's a little faster. It's like a T20 version of the sport. So it's drawing a lot of attention. So make it also a sport to go out and spectate. Moving on, we also see the Independence Invitational Games. That's athletics. That's going to be at the George Odom Stadium in VA4. Yes, we know the conditions down there. However, we must create a platform for athletes themselves. I mean, yes, they do practice on turf or probably the ground or the Minifield Park, but we have a good track down there, and again, they need to showcase themselves. So it's a spectacle that you could really take in. International free-on-free basketball finals on the 25th at the VG Multipurpose Sports Complex, put on by the St. Lucia Basketball Federation. Free-on-free, excitement, fast pace, drawing loads of attention. When we speak of basketball, it's normally 5 against 5, or those guys play 21. But the free-on-free is certainly catching on, so definitely you want to be part of that. Male and female, that is. Thank you, Minister. Male and female, of course, we also want to engage the ladies. So we have also the Independence Challenge Swim Meet, February 26th at the Rodney Heights Aquatic Center, 10 a.m. swimming, St. Lucia Amateur Swimming Association. Again, support is needed. You see those youngsters swimming, but if you had the chairs in the crowd, it really spurs them on. And I've often said that whenever there is a meet, there's always some sort of record being broken. So again, if you support, who knows? You might just cheer on those youngsters into breaking some island records. Last but least, in terms of the sporting events, February 26th, it is the Invitational Football Tournament, Bacatel Football Club, Marshall Football Council, at the Minifield Park. We know how critical, how important football is to that community, and that is Marshall. And clearly, the minister can compound what I'm saying when he's saying how critical football is to Marshall. If you ask me, if ever there is a community that lives and dies and breathes football, it is the community of Marshall. So certainly taking this one, it's an Invitational Football Tournament, which means you are invited. All you need to do is just get with the guys, put on your team or your registration forms, and be part of this tournament. So, folks, that really brings us to the roundup in terms of sporting events for the 40th anniversary of Independence for Santa Lucia. Again, I love the theme. I love the theme. I don't know who came up with it, but who endorsed it. But I am St. Lucia, and I urge other individuals to be St. Lucia. Ms. McDonald mentioned the diaspora play a role as well to showcase our lovely island of St. Lucia. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Glasgow, for that passionate account of what's happening in terms of sports. Thank you very much to the representatives from the various communities and the various groups. I can tell the public that you see the effort and the passion that goes into planning these activities. So what we really need from the public is the support. These activities will not be successful unless you come out and support. Some of them sound so exciting. I will not be doing the walk-a-thon, but I will definitely be there at the start to wish good luck to those who are heading off to the walk-a-thon. So please take the information you have received here today. Look for them online as well. We have some other persons who are involved in the activities which we have planned for our 30th Independence, not related to sports, related to some other aspects of the celebration. I would now like to invite the representative for the National Youth Council, to speak on behalf of what the youth has planned.
Good morning. Honorable Minister Fortuna Bellrose, P.S. Donovan Williams, and our host today, Nicole McDonald, who is the Communications Officer at the Office of the Prime Minister. Excuse me. So, this year at the 50th Independence celebrations, we have been given an opportunity from the National Youth Council to host a very special activity. Mr. Tennyson Glasgow alluded to earlier that youth or young people are the future of St. Lucia. Now, what I would like to elaborate on is the fact that youth are not just the future of St. Lucia. Youth are the current, youth are today. What we must embrace is that youth are today, and the opportunity is now given for you to get a glimpse into the future with the Youth Exposé. This year, we're going to be displaying some of the talents of our young persons in the arts, in the performing arts. We're going to show you what St. Lucia, what it means to be St. Lucian, what it means to be part of this country, and how we're going to be displaying what the young persons have to offer. So we're going to have a Youth Exposé, and that is basically, in a nutshell, the talents and the expressions and the vibrancy of young people in St. Lucia. So it's basically free. One, that's the main thing about it. It's basically free. And it's going to be between the Constitution Park and the William Peter Boulevard. So we invite everyone, young, old, grown, whoever feel that they can be part of such an activity, whoever feels that they are St. Lucian, come out, come support, come give the young persons the strength that they need. Because we know what is happening today. We know what is happening, well, from the 1st of January 2017, we have been crying so much that young persons are not doing so much positive things. And the PSC alluded to it earlier. We need to be able to contribute positively. We need to be engaging. And again, this is the opportunity right there for the public to come out and support. There are no barriers, nothing keeping you out, no separations. It is the 21st of February from 3 p.m. onward. And basically inviting everyone, young persons, old, and all those who are interested. So that is one activity that the National Youth Council will be hosting and participating in. The second activity is, some people tend to think that it's boring. It is not. But this year, the theme will bring out St. Lucians. I know for a fact, we're going to be discussing CIP and the benefits in the time of independence, the benefits of such an initiative to St. Lucia, while basically discussing the pros and cons of such a program. Young people will be discussing it. Though you're not hearing from the parliamentarians. You're not hearing from the decision makers. You're hearing from the young people themselves. How beneficial is CIP to St. Lucia? How is it that we can engage and be part of such an initiative, and what it is that we should expect from it? So the young persons are going to give their views from all around the island. Every corner of St. Lucia, they're going to be debating on this topic. It's going to be at the House of Parliament from 10 a.m. on the 24th of February. So two activities youth are going to be engaged in. Choose one, choose both. Come to every activity if you can, but then we ask you to be part of the celebrations this year. So thank you for having me, and thank you for listening to what the National Young, Youth Council and the young people have on offer for this year. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kelvin. Thank you so much for that overview of some of what the youth is participating in. I know that the Youth Parliament will be very exciting with that topic, and I'm sure certain agreements which are in the news right now will come up as well. So definitely the public should be excited about. I think it will be carried live as well, so persons can tune in if you're not able to make it to Parliament for that session. I do want to invite Mr. Frederick back on stage to deliver an overview of the prayer and praise and worship which we have planned for the anniversary as well.
Honorable Minister, Permanent Secretary in the Department of Equity, Social Justice and Empowerment, and our host, Ms. McDonald, thank you for the opportunity to speak on one of the staple events every year annually, which is the church service in celebration of our independence. Basically, the Prime Minister indicated this year that he wanted to have something more festive, in that we come to give praise, glory, and worship to God. So we have moved away from the traditional kind of church service within four walls, and this year, we're going to be having it at the Boseju Cricket Ground, the Darren Sammy Cricket Ground. And it's going to be on Sunday afternoon, February 19th, from 3:30 to about 6:30. And we are inviting churches from across the island. It doesn't matter what denomination. We're just inviting everyone to come and celebrate. So the name of that event is the Prayer, Praise, and Worship Celebration, where we are coming to reflect, and even in mind with the theme, I am Saint Lucia. So we, as Saint Lucians, we are going to reflect at where God has taken us as a nation, where we are right now, and where we would like him to continue leading us as a nation. And part of that service is going to include a time of, you know, reflection, thinking about different aspects of our society. Various prayers will be offered by the ministers of religion and other members of the laity. So it's going to be really a day to bring praise and honor to God and worship him for sustaining us as a nation. You know, we already had our first meeting with the leaders of various umbrella church organizations. The Pentecostals were in attendance, the Full Gospel Fellowship, and various other independent, non-denominational, faith-based organizations. And basically, we have already picked out our key verse of scripture. We have already started putting in place who will be presenting. So we're going to be having alternate performances, choreography and dance. There might be some poems. And definitely, lots of prayer will be offered on behalf of the nation. And we have asked, since it is a Sunday, that whether the church leaders could tailor their usual Sunday service to have it end a little earlier than usual so that everyone can make it to the big grand event on the Sunday afternoon. But preceding that, again, the Prime Minister had indicated that he wants us to have something called a National Day of Prayer and Rededication for our people and country. And that will be held on Friday, the 17th of February. And basically, it's going to entail several different prayers offered. And basically, everyone is being invited to tune in to the hourly prayer broadcast on radio and television between 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. on that Friday. And we're also asking members of the religious community whether they could have their places of worship opened during that day so that the congregants would be able to go in and have some prayers, meditation, even fasting on behalf of the nation. We're also asking the corporate citizens, corporate business places, whether they could hold a staff meeting during on that morning and call members of staff to pray. Also the schools, whether the school principals could have general assemblies and allow students to pray on behalf of our nation. And some of the prayers that we would like to air throughout the course of the day is a prayer for the youth, prayer for our economy, commerce, business, trade, agriculture, prayer for the schools, prayer for even our national security, the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, firefighters, the bodily officers, security guards, and even watchmen. Some other prayers we would like to have are for prayers for our nurses and medical practitioners, and also prayer for our religious community for the commitment of believers to the faith. So again, we're seeing that this Independence Year of Celebration is really going to have a foundation on our Christian principles, what has built us as a nation and has preserved us to this day. So we are inviting everyone on that Sunday to come and be a part of the Prayer, Praise, and Worship Celebration.
Thank you very much, Mr. Frederick. No doubt this will be a very unifying event for our entire community. I do call on the private sector again to lend support to this. This is very important, and obviously it would bring your team together and feel like you're part of something much, much bigger than your own. I would now like to invite, finally, the PS in the Department of Culture and Local Government to speak to the Best of Saint Lucia initiative, which is also forming part of the activities. Welcoming back again.
I'm tempted to say you saved the best, the best for last. Okay, this activity really is an attempt to bring a real culmination to our celebrations. And it is also an attempt to take some of the traditional things that we did and place it in a package that perhaps would appeal more to a wider group of St. Lucians and certainly appeal to families, because I think part of what we want to do is to ensure that we have the participation of families. Traditionally, we've celebrated independence with your military parade, your youth rally, and it's sometimes been seen as somewhat disjointed. What we have attempted to do is to have one activity which captures all of those elements together. And so I think what we've attempted to do with this particular event is to truly showcase what is the best about St. Lucia. So it will include a parade, a military parade. It will include a rally. But as part of that package, it will include performances, and performances which truly depict the best of St. Lucia. One of the things that marks us out as St. Lucians is our capacity and our appetite to celebrate, to party, to come together and really unite in celebration. And so this activity really is designed to bring all of that together as one, bring us together as one, bring the close, if you like, of the celebration of independence to something that is big, that is rewarding. And so we will hopefully have a reflection of the best. So the best of St. Lucian culture, the best of St. Lucian dancers, the best of St. Lucian music, and even in the category of music, all different genres of music. The best of Kaiso, the best of Soca, the best R&B, if you like, the best of Pan. It is really to showcase everything that is good. Quite apart from the musical and the performance-based activities, we're also going to be showcasing other aspects of St. Lucian's life. So the best of St. Lucian cuisine is going to be a major feature of this. The best of St. Lucian art is going to be a major activity here. And again, opportunities exist for all of those involved in those different areas to come out, showcase, enlighten in many instances all that is good, all that is best about St. Lucia. As we move closer towards the celebration, we will give the general public a greater sense of the specifics, who is going to be involved, etc. But I think as a taste, it should whet our appetites, and it should encourage us as community and as family to make sure that we celebrate the Day of Independence with something that is grand, something that is spectacular, and something that will keep us united and proud. Thank you.
Thank you again, P.S. Williams. I would now like to open up the floor to any questions we might have for the Honorable Minister and the P.S. And obviously members of the committee who are here who can also lend support to answering those questions. We have a question in the back.
Theme, I am St. Lucia. Can we translate this in Creole? I think we need to give a little more thought to our St. Lucian culture if we want to embrace all our St. Lucian language. I think we need to consider that. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, point taken. Moi, c'est Saint Lucien. Yes, it's perhaps an oversight, but clearly we would be making the adjustments.
Do we have any other questions from the audience? Yes. Just please introduce yourself before you ask the question.
John Mitchell, Northern Long Distance Walking Libre. Over the last 4 years, we have been involved in the
this independence challenge. We have been ending almost alone, except for last year to some extent, because we ended with the activities that were taking place. It is somewhat discouraging after, in some cases, some persons have worked for as long as 38 hours to end and end alone. Mm-hmm. To encourage persons, participants, to feel just a little more excited about it, I'm wondering whether this year, in particular, we couldn't cause, from the committee side of things, a welcome that would make her feel welcome. We have the first persons who have ended the walk have been the ones welcoming and the other participants. And you end up feeling like, oh God, it was a waste of time. Though there's the joy that you did it, but no one to have witnessed you doing it. So let's hope this year we see a better representation of the committee and ministers of government.
I think that can that's definitely a request that can be arranged. I think with people being able to go live now, even on Facebook, people can maybe keep track of the walkers a little bit better, so we know what time you're actually getting to that finish line, and we can have a welcome committee there to meet you, to meet the winners. Yes. Okay.
Good morning, Sumon Plaisy, part of the planning committee. Though PS had mentioned the 22nd being a grand day, we'd also like to make mention of the 26th of February being really the end of the celebrations. Our PM made specific mention of ensuring that the planning committee includes Viewfort, the south of the island, in its activities, and we will be having a family beach bash. During this beach bash, you will, again, sports will be a highlight. We have invited the motocross guys to also be part of this activity. So we're inviting St. Lucians to end the celebrations down in Viewfort on the 26th of February. Thank you. And I'll also like to mention Creole, definitely, it will be part of all the activities that we'll be hosting for the season.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Monplaisy. Do we have any other questions from the audience? Okay, I will just ask the minister to say some final words before we wrap up, just to bring everything together, Honorable Minister.
Thank you, Nicole. Thank you, Nicole, but it's basically just to echo the plea and to encourage all St. Lucians to come out and support the event. And the event is for all St. Lucians. I know my Creole-speaking friend mentioned the fact that we didn't mention anything in Creole, but of course, St. Lucia belongs to all of us. Ek nou tout pasaw je pale patwa, me nou ka apwese sa our history has done for us. Now, you see, I'm gone. That's why I didn't use the patois. But of course, to be St. Lucian is to be able to articulate ourselves clearly in the Creole language as well. And a lot of us are working on it, like myself. And of course, we're just happy that we're able to celebrate 38 years. 38 years of independence, 38 years of freedom, 38 years. And like Nicole said, we are mature. We're supposed to know exactly where we're going. And the sad thing is, not every St. Lucian can say the same thing. And we really want to be in a place where we all can be singing from the same song sheet about our country. And we want to know that through the program this year, we can provide the opportunity for reflection, engagement, and of course, helping all of us to reshape, you know, the direction that we would want to go in our own personal lives. And so in the process, contributing
to the development of our own country. So we want to say thank you to everybody. Thank you to the committee that has worked so hard to put the program together. Mr. PS, we could not have done it without you and your wonderful team. The enthusiasm of all the groups, as you see, the passion was displayed in the presentations this morning. We just hope that the rest of the country now can come in and participate and be a part of this wonderful journey of 38 years of St. Lucian success and history. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister. I do want to mention that one of our official activities on the calendar begins this evening. It's constitutional discourse. It's being moderated by Mrs. Kim St. Rose. And also she has an excellent panel of lawyers, and they will be going into details in terms of our fundamental rights and freedoms. This is open to the public, and you can find out more information on the scheduled activities on the government website. I assume it will be or should have been uploaded already. I hope I'm not preempting them, but I hope they do it right away. So persons can go to that website and see all the activities that they would want to partake in. I want to thank the Honorable Minister for being with us this morning. I want to also thank the PS in the Department of Culture and Local Government. Thank you to members of the media. Thank you to members of the Independence Committee. Thank you to persons who are so passionate about the activities that you have been planning. You can see from today that you will get more government support if you're not getting that already. So thank you, everybody. And I will just end with saying, I am St. Lucia. We are all St. Lucia. Thank you.